This is MJ with MinIO. Welcome back to the Kubernetes overview portion of the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course.
So the first topic we're going to cover is namespaces. And namespaces are sort of the foundation of where workloads get deployed within a particular Kubernetes cluster. So namespaces provide a mechanism for isolating resources within a single cluster. Think of this as if you have multiple different groups working on that cluster or multiple different areas of separation within your organization. You could provide them with a namespace or multiple namespaces where they can put their workloads that are only for those specific workloads and separates it from other workloads in the cluster. It's a way to divide cluster resources as well between multiple users. So basically you can assign resource quotas to those individual namespaces so that individual groups or users do not use too much of the resources outside of what is designated for them. It's designed for use in environments where many users spread across multiple teams and projects, and it provides a scope for names. Names of resources need to be unique within a namespace, but not across the namespaces. So if someone tried to deploy something with the same name, but they are in separate namespaces, it will still work. Whereas if you were trying to deploy something with the same name inside a namespace, that will not work. So it really lets different groups operate separately and potentially even use the same configurations without conflicting with one another because they are landing in different namespaces. So now that we've talked about namespaces, I'm going to give you a quick demo of what namespaces look like inside a cluster. I'm going to be using the kubectl command for all of these. So first, let's take a look at our nodes. We see that we have six nodes. We have three server nodes and three agent nodes. So basically servers are managing everything and the agents are what will be running the workloads. And if we do a kubectl get ns for namespaces, you can see that these are the namespaces that currently exist. Now I've aliased within Linux, so if you're familiar with aliases, I've just aliased kubectl to k, so I don't have to keep typing it as much. I recommend you do the same, unless k, of course, is something else already in your system, then you'll have to find a new command, but I will be using k from here on out. So if I do k get ns, you can see that that shows what it showed before. So the first thing I'm going to do is to create a brand new namespace. So we'll do k create ns MinIO. If I run that previous command again, you'll see that there's a new namespace called MinIO. So this is from the command line, but the recommended way is that you write this as YAML. So if we look at our namespace code, you can see that this is what the YAML would look like to be able to deploy this. This is a Kubernetes manifest that would deploy a namespace called MinIO1. So let's go ahead and apply that. K apply minus F and then the file name. In this case, I want to do the namespace.yaml. And now if we go look at our namespaces again, we can see that now there's a MinIO1 namespace as well. So that's the basics of namespaces. And again, look at these as buckets of places where you can define resource quotas and specific workloads will be able to be targeted at these namespaces.
Thanks for joining us for this Kubernetes overview topic as part of the MinIO on Kubernetes and MinIO Operator course. We look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks and have a good one.